Now that we've got it to here, how do you get it to here? We're going to show you how to get it done. And the good news is, the same installation techniques are used with the entire Sabella collection, from the economical Sabella Prime to the stunning Sabella Omni HD. The Sabella product must be stored in an indoor controlled environment that is approximately the same temperature and humidity of where it will be installed. The ideal temperature range is between 65 and 85 degrees Fahrenheit. Regardless of whether the installation takes place in a new construction project or in a renovation project, the job site needs to be made resilient ready. Resilient ready requires that the area is temperature and humidity controlled, and that the subfloor is structurally sound, smooth, clean, and dry. The subfloor can be concrete, wood panel, or a single layer of existing resilient, as long as it meets the resilient ready criteria. One final word on subfloors. Concrete subfloors with controlled in-floor hydroponic radiant heating systems are acceptable. However, we do not recommend installing Sabella over wood subfloor systems that have in-floor or underfloor radiant heating systems. The fiberglass reinforced vinyl back construction of Sabella does offer installation options. They are loose lay, permanent bond, or releasable bond. The loose lay method is most appropriate when the job site is not too complicated and where no more than one major seam may be required. The loose lay option affords the opportunity to install over many substrates that may not be appropriate for fully adhered installation. Particle board, chip board, flake board, lightweight concrete systems, and existing resilient floor coverings, for example. The Sabella must be lying flat and positioned squarely in the room. Provide a gap of 1/8 to 1/4 inch all around the edges of the Sabella flooring. Do not secure cabinets or other permanent fixtures on top of loose lay Sabella. If a seam is required, it should be double cut net with no fullness or gaps, and secure to the substrate with a 6-inch wide band of MT711 applied with a 1/32 inch notch trowel. The fully adhered permanent bond option is the most secure and is the best option if there is heavy foot traffic or rolling traffic. The layout is cut up and complicated. Because the permanent bond is achieved by placing the Sabella into tacky wet MT711, applied with a 1/16 inch by 1/32 inch deep by 1/32 inch space notch trowel, the substrate must be smooth and have sufficient porosity to receive the adhesive. In most cases, this requires the use of an appropriate underlayment over wood substrates, that the concrete surface is smooth using an appropriate Portland cement packing compound, such as Mannington MVP 2023, and that an embossing leather, again such as Mannington MVP 2023 plus additive, be used over existing resilient or ceramic floors. Additionally, the Sabella should be rolled in both directions with a 50-pound or heavier 3-section floor roller. The fully adhered releasable bond option is viable over concrete and most wood panel substrates in use in climate-controlled, occupied existing homes. Unconditioned wood panel substrates are not dimensionally stable and are subject to too much movement. To achieve a releasable bond, the MT711 is applied over the substrate with a 3/8-inch nap paint roller and allowed to dry before positioning the Sabella into the adhesive. The Sabella is then positioned into the dry adhesive and smoothed out with the use of a clean, soft, bristle push broom. Because of the thin, dry adhesive film, this method can be used with many types of substrates, including clean, lightly embossed existing resilient flooring without the use of a leveler, or over clean, dry, and smooth OSB substrates without extraordinary floor prep. The coverage rate of the MT711 adhesive will be increased to approximately 300 square feet per gallon when applied with a paint roller. Regardless of the installation method, Sabella must always be trimmed back 1/8 to 1/4 inch from all fixed vertical surfaces and must be fit with no compression or fullness. Undercut all door casings and be certain the material is positioned true and square in the work area. Because the Sabella product construction cannot be compressed or stretched into mesh, the seams must be double cut net with no fullness. Overlap the sheets to bring the pattern into mesh and cut through both sheets at the same time. Using a straight edge as a guide and a utility knife with a sharp blade, cut along the grout line. Once the seam is cut, fold back the sheets and apply MT711 adhesive. Let the adhesive tack up appropriately and then carefully position the sheets without dragging adhesive into the seam cut. All seams of Sabella must be sealed using MLG 33 low gloss seam sealer. Be certain to thoroughly blend both parts A and B in the supplied applicator bottle and let any bubbles that develop during mixing disperse before using. Insert the fin of the applicator bottle into the seam cut and apply a controlled uniform bead of sealer into and on top of the seam. Do not wipe off. Do not disturb the walk on the sealer until fully cured and dry. Sabella, the right flooring product for any room in your home with the installation options that provide performance properties to keep it beautiful as well. Mannington Sabella, the perfect flooring solution.